الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله. I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for another day of Ramadan and another day of fasting, and alhamdulillah for the good health and for the peace. Dear brothers and sisters, we stopped at the end of chapter 6, and inshallah we can start chapter 7. And in chapter 7, part of it is in Surah Al-Ma'idah, and the other part is Surah Al-An'am. So I want to, inshallah, read just a few pages, verses of Surah Al-Ma'idah toward the end, and continue and summarize the talk about Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And then, inshallah, Surah Al-An'am will cover a few aspects, and inshallah, we'll come to the conclusion at the end of the hour. So we are in verse number 110 of Surah Al-Ma'idah. وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى. If anybody have a Quran and want to follow us, inshallah, will be great. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم اذكر نعمتي عليك وعلى والدتك إذ أيدتك بروح القدس تكلم الناس في المهد وكهلا وإذ علمتك الكتاب والحكمة والتوراة والإنجيل وإذ تخلق من الطين كهيئة الطير بإذني فتنفخ فيها فتكون طيرا بإذني وتبرئ الأكمه والأبرص بإذني وإذ تخرج الموتى بإذني وإذ كففت بني إسرائيل عنك إذ جئتهم بالبينات فقال الذين كفروا منهم إن هذا إلا سحر مبين وإذ أوحيت إلى الحواريين أن آمنوا بي وبرسولي قالوا آمنا واشهد بأننا مسلمون إذ قال الحواريون يا عيسى ابن مريم هل يستطيع ربك أن ينزل علينا مائدة من السماء قال اتقوا الله إن كنتم مؤمنين قالوا نريد أن نأكل منها وتطمئن قلوبنا ونعلم أن قد صدقتنا ونكون عليها من الشاهدين قال عيسى بن مريم اللهم ربنا أنزل علينا مائدة من السماء تكون لنا عيدا لأولنا وآخرنا وآية منك وارزقنا وأنت خير الرازقين قال الله إني منزلها عليكم فمن يكفر بعد منكم فإني أعذبه عذابا لا أعذبه أحدا من العالمين وإذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله قال سبحانك ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي بحق إن كنت قلته فقد علمته تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك إنك أنت علام الغيوب ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم وكنت عليهم شهيدا ما دمت فيهم فلما توفيتني كنت أنت الرقيب عليهم وأنت على كل شيء شهيد إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت العزيز الحكيم قال الله هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك الفوز العظيم لله ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن وهو على كل شيء قدير آمنت بالله صدق الله العظيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. Dear brothers and sisters, here is the ayat that summarizing the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And as we said, Surah Ali Imran before, Surah Al-Ma'ida and Surah Al-An'am, and a few other surahs, of course, like Maryam and others, they are talking about Sayyidina Musa, Isa alayhi salam, and mentioning the details about his da'wah and his life. So really, literally, as somebody said, that Muslims know about Isa more than Christians. They know about Isa. And in fact, it's been mentioned in the Quran much, much more than it's mentioned in anywhere else. Right after Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. And many times more than Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, it's been said that it's mentioned 25 times. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. More than that would be Musa and to a certain degree less Ibrahim alayhi salam and Nuh and the rest of the prophets. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned twice in his direct name as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and insinuating and directing the mentioning of him in the Quran in few other places. So let me cover this inshallah meaning briefly and we'll move on to Surah Al-An'am. And then, inshallah, we'll open for question and answer as we do every time we meet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, إِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمْ اُذْكُرْ نِعْمَتِي عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَى وَالِدَتِكَ إِذْ أَيَّدْتُكَ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ تُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam of remembering the blessings of Allah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have supported Isa alayhi salam and his mom with Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, Ruh al-Qudus, Jibreel alayhi salam, and the power of Allah that invested in him, in Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, to stand by Isa and his mom during their trial, whether it is before she became pregnant, during and after she had Isa alayhi salam as a baby and when he grown up. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding Isa, تُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلَ, that you talk to the people when you were little, in the cradle, baby. In fact, in the first few days when she brought him, فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ in Surah Maryam, قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيَّ. They said, how come you are telling us to talk to him? He was a little baby in Mahd, in the cradle. قَالَتْ قال عليه السلام الله سبحانه وتعالى released his tongue to say even he was a little baby قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب I am the servant of Allah I am عبد الله آتاني الكتاب he will send me a revelation from Allah وجعلني نبيا and make me a prophet so عيسى عليه السلام talked to the people when he was little and then talked to the people when he was كهلة Kahla is middle age, from the 30 to the 40s. The person who reached that level age, middle age, between 30 years old and 40 years old, will call him Kahla. It could be also up to 50 years old, but anywhere after 30 years old will be Kahla. Before that, we'll say young man, like, you know, Shabab. وَإِذْ عَلَّمْتُكَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning the blessings of knowledge. Of knowledge that Allah revealed to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, عَلَّمْتُكَ. Ta'lim, dear brother and sister, is blessings of Allah. Any form of knowledge that is good, beneficial to you, to the people, to the community, is a blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَّمْتُكَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. Al-kitab is the book. Hikmah is wisdom. And that could be also revelation in different forms, which is the inspiration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet alayhi wassalam. Al-hikmah, wal-tawrata wal-injil. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Sayyidina Musa alayhi, Isa alayhi salam, al-tawrat, the book of Musa. And al-injil is the revelation that Allah gave to Isa alayhi salam during his lifetime. And then Allah remind Isa alayhi salam and us, of course, to know that Isa was a prophet of Allah, a human. And Allah put some miracles on his hand so people can accept. وَإِذْ تَخْلُقُ مِنَ الطِّينِ كَهَيْئَةِ الطَّيْرِ فَالطَّيْرِ بِإِذْنِي. That you will make a sculptures of clay and dough of clay. You make it look like a bird and you order it by the will of Allah to fly. And it will fly by the will of Allah. فَتَكُونُ طَيْرًا بِإِذْنِي. So you make it from clay in front of the people's eye, and then you say, fly in the name of Allah, and it will fly. That is by the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتُبْرِئُ الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَسِ. And then you are healing the people who were sick, whether they are blind or they have skin problem. Abras, like white and black and dark and different, like, you know, situation. And akmah is the one who cannot talk. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will talk. And bi'idhni, in permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa tukhriju al-mawta bi'idhni. And Isa alayhi salam had the power, by the will of Allah, to tell the dead person to wake up and to talk, and that person will survive and talk and live by the will of Allah. وَإِذْ كَفَفْتُ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَنْكَ إِذْ جِئْتَهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ فَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. So this is the response of the people. Unfortunately, sometimes people ask for miracles, that even if you bring the miracles, they will reject, like they did with Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. One time they were sitting around in Mecca, around the Kaaba, and they looked to the moon, which was full moon, and they said, oh Muhammad, can you divide this moon? And Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you know, he was not expecting that. And he said, in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the moon, he make his sign, like, you know, ashara ila al-moon, ila al-qamar, the moon, and the moon split. And they have seen it in their eyes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran, اقتربتِ السَّاعَةُ وَانْشَقَّ الْقَمَرِ. The day of judgment comes when Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because he's the last prophet, and then the Qamar is being split. And yet after that, they said, oh, he is a sahir. He is a magician. He just make us feel that way. And here with Sayyidina Isa Alayhi Salam, they say the same thing. But I want to mention to you that look at the miracles that Sayyidina Isa Alayhi Salam performed, comparing to the miracles that Sayyidina Musa or Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم performed. The miracles during the time of Sayyidina Isa عليه السلام, all of it related to the, you can say, medical field, the well-being of the human being, the medicine, akmah, that's a person who is like, cannot see and cannot talk. Abras, have some skin problem. Tayr, give life to dead things, like the clay that he made it with, and revealing or bringing back a dead person from death into life. All of those are related to medical things. And they said that in the tafsir, that because during the time of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, medicine was advanced. was at that time like the bride of the nation. People are so, let's say, taken, so much taken by the medical achievements. During the time of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, people were taken by magicians, by magic, by who perform a stronger and better and bigger magic. And that's where it comes to the snake and to many other things that Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam performed. During the time of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, it wasn't that kind. It was more of eloquency and power and kind of, you know, arrogancy and different stuff. So Rasulullah performed few related to few miracles that's so strong and powerful. Of course, the Quran al-Azim is one of them, and his statement, and as we know, splitting of the moon, and when he had a river going between his fingers, water coming out, when he blessed the food, and so many other miracles. So different environment require different type of miracles so people can hopefully accept. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after you bring them al-bayyinat, after you bring the ayat and all the miracles, evidence, قَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. This is only magic that's been performed on us, and they will not accept. Unfortunately, they will change their mind after that. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Hawariyin. Hawariyin here is the people who accepted Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam as Prophet of Allah. And every people who accepted the Prophet, they will be called Hawariyin. In terms of Rasul sallallahu alayhi salam, they will be called companion, ashab or sahaba. And this is very honorable terms that you say sometimes. Sahib. Sahib is like companion, somebody that you spend time with. And at the time of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Allah named them Hawariyin, people who follow and obey, and they will become like a supportive of the Prophet alayhi salam. إِذْ قَالَ الْحَوَارِيُّونَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Hawariyin, وَإِذْ أَوْحَيْتُ إِلَى الْحَوَارِيِّينَ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِي وَبِرَسُولِي. I encouraged them and I inspired them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired the Hawariyin to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet alayhi salam. At that time, Isa alayhi salam. قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَشْهَدْ بِأَنَّنَا مُسْلِمُونَ. So they said, yes, we believe, Ya Allah, and you are our witness that we are Muslims. We are submitting to the will of Allah, the order of the Prophet alayhi salam, Isa at the time. إِذْ قَالَ الْحَوَارِيُّونَ يَا عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. Here the Hawariyin themselves, they challenge Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And we know that the people of Bani Israel, they have challenged Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam so many times. Except the Sahaba, radiallahu anhum. They have not challenged Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam in any situation. When he asked them to migrate, they said, we are ready to migrate. They left everything and they left fi sabilillah. When he asked them to fight, they fight. In terms of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when he told the people to fight, they said, no. You go, you and your Lord, and fight. We are sitting here. اِذْهَبْ أَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَا إِنَّهَا هُنَا قَاعِدُونَ. And when he told them to cross the ocean, they said, oh no, they're going to be catching us or catching us. We are not going to be saved and so forth. He said, no, that's not true. مَعْيَ رَبِّي. I have my Lord with me, and he will find a way out for us. فَقُلْ نَضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Musa alayhi salam to hit the ocean and will be open to be road. And many other stories of both Sayyidina Musa and Isa alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that those people of Maryam of Isa ibn Maryam, they said that we are hungry. And that is legitimate like concern and asking. And so many times the Sahaba told the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we are hungry. But they never asked, Ya Rasulullah, why not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send us basket of food from heaven? But those people, they said, قَالُوا يَا عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمْ, O Prophet of Allah, son of Mary, هَلْ يَسْتَطِيعُ رَبُّكَ, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord, able to send us a banquet or table full of food? Like we need to eat from it, from heaven, send it from heaven. you know, that is a very strange question. And they said that we need to eat from it and to feel like, you know, confident that you tell us the truth and that you are prophet of God, and it will be like kind of conditional iman. ونعلم أن قد صدقتنا وكون عليها من الشاهدين. عيسى عليه السلام قال قال عيسى عليه السلام اللهم ربنا أنزل علينا مائدة من السماء. He said, okay, if you are really insisting and you want, it will be. Allah سبحانه وتعالى على كل شيء قدير. عيسى عليه السلام and مريم عليه السلام and all prophets of Allah and strong believers, they know that إن الله على كل شيء قدير. Allah سبحانه وتعالى can bring it from heaven, and He did to Maryam. When she was in the mihrab, when she was isolated by herself, she will get the food of like the winter time at the summer time, and the fruit of the summer time at the winter time. And when Zakaria alayhi salam will ask her, where is this from? She said, min indillah, inna Allah yarzuq man yashau bighayri hisab, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it to me through the angels. So he said, Allahumma rabbana anzil alayhi ma. He said, Ya Allah, send us a table full of food. A table, when the table is full of food, then become ma'idah. The word ma'idah means table full of food. So whether it is on the ground, the floor, or rising up, or doesn't matter. The main thing is it's like a table that has food people can eat. Then it'll become ma'idah. It'll be like banquet or some place where you enjoy your food. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Isa alayhi salam, he said, Ya Allah, this will be like a landmark for us. This will be the day of celebration. عِيدًا لِأَوَّلِنَا وَآخِرِينَ, for us and for the later on the nation or the people who will come after us. وَرْزُقْنَا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ, Ya Allah, bless us and provide for us and sustain us. قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنِّي مُنَزِّلُهَا عَلَيْكُمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His rahmah and mercy, He said, yes, I am going to send you one. But you have to be careful. فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ مِنْكُمْ فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بَعْدُ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنِّي أُعَذِّبُ عَذَابًا لَا أُعَذِّبُ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. Then this is a great deal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you a miracles that you will never seen before and probably will never see after. But make sure that anybody will deny or do anything wrong, he will be punished severely in this life and in the life after. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers and sisters, want to, as we say, go all the way with the servant or with the prophets to make sure that they have all what it takes to convince the people or to have the evidence against the people that you have no choice but to accept. And when they don't, they are kafirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment, He said that toward the end here, that Allah will ask Isa alayhi salam, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ, Isa, have you said to the people to worship me and my mother, Maryam عليه السلام, as a two gods, إلهين من دون الله؟ قال سبحانك, He said, you know, glory to Allah. It is منزه, تسبيح لله. ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي بعلم بحق. I have no right to say things from my own. It is not my right. I am a creation of yours, Ya Allah. And that's the status of all prophets of Allah. And all humble, decent people, they will never relate things to themselves. They all related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will say, somebody asks you, you did this one? He said, yeah, I did it by the will of Allah. Alhamdulillah, bi'awnillah. And I didn't do it on my own power. But by the will of Allah, everything will happen. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Isa alayhi salam told, Ya Rab, my Lord, إن كنت قلته فقد علمت تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك إنك أنت علام الغيوب. Oh my Lord, if I have said it, you would have known that. And if you know that, I would have said something that's not my right, you will not allow me. You will punish me. You will reprimand me. You will stop me. Even for less than that, way less than that, of course. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers and sisters, if you know that during the time of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam growing, when he was like less than 19, 20 years old, he was helping in some building, even in the building of the Kaaba at the time. Yes, the building of the Kaaba. and they were carrying some small rocks from around the Kaaba, from the mountains to the Kaaba. And the young kids, they are taking off their clothing and put it on their shoulders, and their awra, their like, you know, private parts are showing. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam want to do the same. Took off his like izar, his clothing that's covering him. And the minute he did, he dropped and he stopped and he went to sleep. And he did not get exposed, and none of the people at the time have seen him without proper clothing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will interfere with his power one way or another. And we know the story of Abasa wa Tawalla, when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not stop properly to the blind man who want to ask him about Islam. And he was kind of rushing him, and he want to go to meet the leaders of Quraysh, hoping that they will accept Islam and Islam will be accepted by Quraysh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reprimanded him. He said, how come? Abasa wa tawalla, and ja'ahu al-a'ma. And then to the end of the ayat, وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ يَزَّكَّى وَيَذَّكَّرَ فَتَنْفَعُ الذِّكْرَ. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I was afraid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish me severely for that. But Allah just mentioned it in indirect way to make him feel like, you know, this is not the way it should be done by a great prophet like you. And he felt so bad about it. And he asked Abdullah to forgive Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to and he used to stop with him again. And in fact, he assigned him as a muadhin, as we know. So it is not up to the prophets or any prophet to do and to say anything from their own. Rather, it is inspiration and guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah telling us that Isa alayhi salam told them, مَا قُلْتُ لَهُمْ إِلَّا مَا أَمَرْتَنِي بِهِ أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ وَرَبَّكُمْ وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ فَلَمَّا تَوَفَّيْتَنِي كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٌ. I have told them only what you told me, Ya Allah. And I never told them that me or my mom are gods or a deity or anything like that. And you were my witness while I was among them. فَلَمَّا تَوَفَّيْتَنِي كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ. And the word, dear brothers and sisters, تَوَفَّيْتَنِي doesn't mean مُوَفَّى or مُتَوَفَّى in terms of like dead. مُتَوَفَّى is taken out, is not exist anymore, or not the presence in the full capacity. And that is Isa alayhi salam. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him and took him to the heaven. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that shaheed on the people. So those people who claim other than the fact that Isa alayhi salam is a prophet of Allah, they will have to prove it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise Allah will be their witness and will testify against them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that Isa alayhi salam at the time, out of his kindness and mercy, he said, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ. If you punish them, you have a full right, Ya Allah, you are the creator. They are servants and they are creation of yours. إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And if you forgive them, you are Al-Aziz Al-Hakim. You are the Almighty, you are the most wise. And dear brothers and sisters, when Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam recited this ayah, among, of course, others, he was praying with this. And when he arrived to this ayah, which is one ayah before the end, he repeated all night long, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ. If you punish them, Ya Allah, they are deserving and they are your servant. وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And if you forgive them, you are the Almighty God who deserve, who are qualified, or ahlun. That's mean he's like qualified by all means to forgive, and he is almighty and all wise. And he repeated that because the meaning of this, Ya Allah, the people affair is in your hand. Even those mushrikeen, as we say, the ahlul kitab, the kafirin, the claim that Isa alayhi salam is God or son of God, or the one who claimed that Maryam is God, or mother of God, or any of that claim that is false. they still are people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكْ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. So they may have a chance for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who determined that.
قَالَ اللَّهُ هَذَا يَوْمُ يَنْفَعُ الصَّادِقِينَ صِدْقُهُمْ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is the day of judgment, where the truth-telling and the people who believed in the truth, their belief and their صدق, their truthfulness will be benefiting them. يَنْفَعُ الصَّادِقِينَ صِدْقُهُمْ
تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ.
سبحان الله. This ayah so great, so meaningful, so covering. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you know what? All what you are about in this dunya, maybe nobody know fully except Allah. Allah know the sadiq from the one who is not sadiq. The one who is playing games and the one who is hypocrites and from the one that is really truthful. And this is the day where that truthfulness, sadiq, amana, trustworthiness, and sadaqah, and tasadduq, and all of those meaning that comes under sadaq, now it will show and it will come to demonstrate who is and who is not. Tajri min tahtihim al-anhar. Rivers will run beneath them and they will be there forever. Final things, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. Allah will be pleased with them. And they will be pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in stored for them in Jannah. ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. What do we want from this dunya? Ultimately, we want some success. فَوْز. To be successful. To pass the test. To have what it takes to make things possible and right. And that's what we are all about. In the who are رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. لله ما في السماوات والأرض وما فيهن وهو على كل شيء قدير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Malik. لله ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن وهو على كل شيء قدير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in control of heaven and earth and everything in between, and Allah is able to do what he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who are رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with their Lord. You may say, how we will be pleased with our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah providing us with life, with sustenance, with peace of mind, with so many faculties, with so many blessings, and iman, and belief, and so on and so forth. What else do you want? And at the end, he's promising you jannat and fawz, success. That is indeed. And Allah, if Allah is radiyallahu anhum, if Allah is pleased with you, you have nobody or nothing else to worry about. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us among those radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. May Allah grant us success in the dunya and the akhirah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from all evils of this life. Dear brothers and sisters, this is the conclusion of Surah Al-Ma'idah. It is wonderful surah. I hope and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who listen and follow and obey and understand. And it concludes about the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam and Maryam. If you have any question, please let me know. And maybe before we go further with Surah Al-An'am, there are so many things to say about Surah Al-An'am as well. And I want to just summarize, inshallah, as much as possible to take us to the end of Surah of chapter 7, inshallah. Anybody would like to say something now? It's about half an hour. I usually like to take a little break or hear you if you have any question. We will cover a few other aspects and we'll bring it to conclusion. And inshallah, we will be all right. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون هو الذي خلقكم من طين ثم قضى أجلا وأجل مسمى عنده ثم أنتم تمترون
تعلمون وهو الله في السماوات وفي الأرض يعلم سركم وجهركم ويعلم ما تكسبون فقد كذبوا بالحق لما جاءهم فسوف يأتيهم أم ما كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا من قبلهم من قرن مكناه في الأرض ما لم نمكن لكم وأرسلنا السماء عليهم مدرارا وجعلنا الأنهار تجري من تحتهم فأهلكناهم بذنوبهم وأنشأنا من بعدهم قرنا آخرين.
صدق الله العظيم. So this is the first six verses of Surah Al-An'am. And dear brothers and sisters, Al-An'am, as we mentioned before, and inshallah to be in the surah again, are those animals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed for us to eat, which is the camel, the cows, the beef, the goats and the lamb. Those are called An'am. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created those of male and female, and make them lawful for us to eat from them, slaughter them, and so on. So, Alhamdulillah, الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created heaven and earth, samawat and earth, وجعل الظلمات والنور. الظلمات, we explain the darkness. And look, here it comes in terms of plural, more than one ظلمة. He did not say al-zalam. وَجَعَلَ الظَّلَامَ وَالنُّورِ. Al-nur is one. Al-zulumat is multiple. And we mentioned that zulumat al-jahiliyyah, economic darkness, educational darkness, belief darkness, practice darkness, social life darkness, all of those are different forms of darkness of jahiliyyah or far away from Islam. Al-nur is one. So when the light comes, all kind of darkness run away. And that is the nur of hidayah. And that's when we say, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. Allah is the source of guidance and the source of light, for heaven and earth. And you may say, well, it is like the sun bring the light. Well, this is the light just for the faculty, for the eyes. And there are so many people who doesn't have an eyes, or they cannot see, but their iman and their heart is full of iman and light. And they can see and they have probably more knowledge and more understanding of life and issues and so forth. So here, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard, that's Allah the source of guidance and the source of seeing the truth. And that's where we have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, Alhamdulillah. And this is one of the surahs first, one of the surahs that start with Alhamdulillah. So far, what do we have? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, which is Surah Al-Fatiha. Here, Alhamdulillahi Alladhi Khalaqa Al-Samawati Wal-Ard. And you have Surah Al-Kahf. Alhamdulillahi Alladhi Anzala Ala Abdihi Al-Kitaba Walam Yaj'al Lahu Iwaja. You have Surah Fatir. Alhamdulillahi Fatir Al-Samawati Wal-Ard. Why start with Alhamdulillah? Like some other surahs, probably we'll mention, inshallah, start with Subhanallah, or Sabbaha Lillahi, or Yusabbihu Lillahi. Alhamdulillah, dear brothers and sisters, is a great ibadah, great ni'mah, something that Allah loves. And as we know, the more you say Alhamdulillah, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And if you know, of course, Alhamdulillah, all of you know, that when we do our ruku', what do we say? Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, in the ruku' and Subhana Rabbi al-A'la in the sujood. But in the ruku', when we rise up, what do we say? Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. Why we say that? We are not saying Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, and then Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. This has a little story that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu never missed Jama'ah and the first rak'ah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in fard. Except one time in the early days. And when he came in last minute and he catched the prayers and he catched the ruku' and he was saying Subhana Rabbil Azim. When he raised his head, he said, Alhamdulillah that I catch the prayers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that to say سمع الله لمن حمده. Allah have heard those who say Alhamdulillah. So to say Alhamdulillah is a great deal. But no matter how many times you say it in your lifetime, it's not enough. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praising himself, because Allah is more capable of praising himself and thanking himself and glorifying himself than us weak creation, vulnerable, unable, and forgettable, and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Alhamdulillah, الذي خلق السماوات والأرض, created heaven and earth, والظلمات والنور. So pay attention to الظلمات والنور too. Because dear brothers and sisters, unfortunately, even Muslims sometimes they go into ظلمات. ظلمات of fitna, ظلمات of wrong practices, ظلمات of شهوات, desires. Some people have certain desires to certain things or habits that is not supposed to be. And all of us are, you know, short of problems like this. We have some problem. But let's pray always to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from that darkness. You know what? Dangerous sometimes. I want to share with you this, even though it's... it is sometimes the shahawat of those people, especially the one that in the first line. In the first line of the masjid, of the salah. They sometimes, some people look at themselves as if, oh, I made it. It's like over. That's it. I am favored because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped me to be in the first line. And they look down sometimes to the person who's coming late or last one or the second line or so on. If anybody have that feeling, you know, rest assured that all what's inside is gone. The prayers, dear brothers and sisters, or the ibadat and the rest of the, you know, teaching, it is like between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the hadith that رُبَّ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرْ لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَا أَبَرَّهِ. Maybe somebody that you'll see, his hair is not organized and his dust all over. And if he swear to Allah or he ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will grant him, will give him. And maybe you and I and others who are, mashallah, getting ready and prepared and so forth, you know, just another person. So we should not have that ظلمات, that darkness in our heart somehow, somewhere. Check in your heart, make sure all of it's lighted. Lightened with love, with mercy, with kindness, with all positive attitude toward others and toward Muslims and people at large. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that He is the one who خلقنا من طين. That's where we are. And then some of us reject and refuse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brother and sister, who said, وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord in heaven and earth. وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ. What that means? That Allah is Allah in heaven and in earth. It is exactly opposite of what the people say sometimes. Leave what for Caesar to Caesars and for God to God. Totally opposite. That Allah is the Lord, the one who is supposed to be worshipped in heaven by angels and other creations. And Allah is the same Allah who is supposed to be worshipped and obeyed and followed in earth. وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ. So we cannot say, you know, leave it to everybody can do whatever they want. We cannot, of course, in terms of aqeedah, yes, we are not forcing people for aqeedah. In many issues that we are not forcing people, لا إكراه في الدين. We mentioned that. There is no compulsion in Islam. But you cannot say that Allah has nothing to do, let's say, in certain aspect of life. The relationship, the economy. Halal and haram, even the food. As we know, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught the people how to go to the bathroom, how to clean yourself. And you know the situation now. Now, America and maybe the West discovered the washing with water as a result of this coronavirus situation. So you may say, what does Islam has to do with the bathroom? Well, a great deal was related of our fiqh, how to make wudu, how to go to the bathroom, clean yourself, whether from al-hadath al-asghar, al-hadath al-akbar, the minor things, the bigger things, the ghusl, all of those are details of the deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has something to say with it, even in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that if there is no water, do tayammum. Who told us about tayammum? Of course, the hay'ah, how to do it, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِن لَمْ تَجِدُوا مَاءً فَتَيَمَّمُوا صَعِيدًا طَيِّبًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that if you don't find water to clean yourself, to get ready, to prepare, to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go to salah, then make tayammum, and that is the minimum requirement. So Allah, it has everything to do in heaven, and Allah has everything to do in earth. Being worshipped, followed ahkam, regulations, and therefore we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be loved and obeyed as ilah, as rabb, and as malik. Ilah is the one who we worship. As rabb is the one he provide and sustain, and as malik is the one in control of do and don't in our life. And there is more details to that. يَعْلَمُ سِرَّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ. Allah knows what you are hiding, and He knows what you are announcing or what you are doing. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُونَ. And Allah knows what you are gaining or losing. Let me just make a comment that you may say, oh, then we don't need the parliamentary or what you call a Congress. We don't need representative of the people. No, we do need representative of the people to talk about the people affair and so forth. But if all people, not only the Congress or Parliament of any nation for that matter, or the whole people of the earth, they have shirk, or they have make what's halal haram and what's haram halal, we say that's invalid, unacceptable, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is ilah in heaven, is ilah on earth, and he determined what's some of those rulings, how it should be. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't rush. فَقَدْ وَمَا آتَاهُمْ وَمَا تَأْتِيهِمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ لَكَانُوا عَنْهَا مُعْرِضِينَ. When the ayat, when the miracles in one hand and the punishment comes in the other hand for the people, they are not accepting. They are not learning from it. They are not taking it as a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know that so many messages Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send in every day and every night. In fact, every day we wake up in the morning, it's a message that, oh my servant, here you are, brought to back to life, and there is light, you can open your eyes and you go around. This is a message that you are getting closer to the end of your life. And we know that Katrina and all those tornadoes and all those fires and all earthquakes and what have you, you may think it's only like, you know, natural phenomena. Yes, they are natural phenomena, but they are also messages from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have to be aware and be concerned. And we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you know, in other ayat, that when we send them to the ocean and there will be winds and waves and they will cry to Allah, Allah will save them and they will bring them back to earth, and then they will reject. إِلَّا كَانُوا عَنْهَا مُعْرِضِينَ. They will go the other way. Let me just conclude here because the time is running. I don't want to keep you too long. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَلَمْ يَرَوْا كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَا لَنْ مَكِّنْ لَكُمْ. What about those nations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed before us or before any nation? So many of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أَهْلَكَهُمْ. Gone. Famine, as we say now, pandemic, maybe floods, maybe, you know, fire, so many things. قوم لوط فجعلنا عاليها سافلها, we turn it upside down, and so many other. Then why we don't learn lesson? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them power that's so strong. I don't know if anybody knows that the people of Ad and Thamud in Jordan, if you go to what they call it Wadi Ram, it's so huge. And then the city of Petra city in Jordan, Amman, you would see those nations build their homes in the desert, in the mountains, in a way it's so magnificent. And they said, "Man ashaddu minna quwwa." Who is more powerful than us? And sometimes, you know, you hear people and politicians say, oh, we are the most powerful nation in the earth. Powerful for what? Ultimately, you know, things could go wrong as it is right now. And people die. You cannot even save them. What, people should not be so arrogant against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كم أهلكنا قبلهم من قرن مكناهم في الأرض ما لم نمكن لكم. We gave them power more than what we gave to you. And that to you could go all the people until the day of judgment. And the people of Egypt, Fir'aun, عاد وثمود لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. Nothing that's been similar to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created as such. So, dear brothers and sisters, we have to be humble and, of course, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His miracles and His power over this world. I am sure there are so many other verses and ayat. I just want to stop here, inshallah, and if you have any questions to talk about or to ask. The surah talks a lot about aqidah matters, issues of iman. Issues of ظلم. قل أرأيتكم إن جاء إن أتاكم عذاب الله بغتة أو جهرة هل يهلك إلا القوم الظالمون. When the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes so severely and so suddenly subhanallah, you know, Thursday we were okay, Friday everything shut down, and you know, at that time the gallon of gas was about $4 plus. And all of a sudden now it's about like $1.50 somewhere. In many states, it's about $1.30 or $1.20. Subhanallah, I remember in 1990, something like in the late 90s, it was 99 cents. Things could happen at any time. And now it's useless. And now they pay you to take it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَتَاكُمْ عَذَابُنَا عَذَابُ اللَّهِ بَغْتَةً. بَغْتَةً is sudden. أو جَهْرَةً in the daytime. Next day, something happened, everything changed. هَلْ يُهْلَكُوا إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Don't be aggressor, don't be arrogant, don't be so evil doers. And there are so many other verses and topics to talk about. Please, if you have any question or comments, I would like to stop here and hear from you. And we have some short announcements, inshallah, to make. Any brothers or sisters have any comments?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.